Hello, I'm Yoon, a tour guide in Seoul. Today, I'd like to introduce Suwon Hwaseong Fortress. Suwon Hwaseong is located in Suwon City, Gyeonggi-do Province, Korea. Suwon Hwaseong was built by King Jeongjo, one of the kings in Joseon Dynasty. Its construction began in 1794. And was completed in 1796 during the late Joseon Dynasty. Not only Eastern architectural technology, but also Western architectural technology was used to build Suwon Hwaseong Fortress. Everyone initially expected the construction of this fortress to take 10 years. But outstanding scholars like Jeong Ya-kyung finished the project in 2 years and 9 months by supervising it and because the technology of Joseon, which was not used in previous buildings, was used in this construction. A representative example of it was the equipment called Geojunggi, invented by Jeong Ya-kyung, one of the most respected figures in Korea. Geojunggi is a kind of crane that uses a pulley or running block. It allowed one person to lift the heavy rock or anything that needs 5 people to lift. His inventions, along with this Geojunggi, greatly reduced the duration of the construction. Furthermore, using his inventions was able to significantly reduce accidents during construction. In Suwon Hwaseong Fortress, various kinds of defense facilities were installed. Suwon Hwaseong Fortress was designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1997 due to its architectural beauty as well as its practicality. Behind the construction of Suwon Hwaseong is the sad family history of King Jeongjo. King Jeongjo had a father called Prince Sado. Prince Sado was such a clever prince that he read a book of difficult Chinese characters in his 3rd year. His father, King Jeongjo, expected him to be a great king. However, his excessive expectations brought tragedy. King Jeongjo was a great king who loved his people with all his heart. But he always sought perfection, and his love for his son began to go astray. While growing up, Crown Prince Sado became more interested in martial arts rather than studying. It greatly disappointed King Jeongjo, so King Jeongjo scolded Sado almost every day. Despite being the king of the future, his father often insulted him in front of many of his officials. It was an intolerable humiliation for a crown prince. Prince Sado was so afraid of his father that he had a heartache. He would tremble with fear when he met his father, King Jeongjo. The death of Crown Prince Sado was due to his treason. Out of his mind, Prince Sado said to his people, "I should do something with the blade," and tried to enter the palace where his father was. But he went back, hesitating about it. Perhaps he was trying to kill his father, King Jeongjo. King Jeongjo found out about it. King Jeongjo summoned Sado and ordered him to commit suicide by handing him a knife. But Prince Sado cried for forgiveness. King Jeongjo eventually locked Sado in a rice box and waited for him to die. Of course, it was in accordance with national law to execute those who tried to assassinate the king. The young Jeongjo, the son of Sado, also witnessed the scene. Young Jeongjo cried and asked his grandfather for forgiveness. 8 days after Prince Sado was locked up in the rice box, he died. King Jeongjo also grieved over his son's death and regretted his mistake, but it was no use. After his son's death, King Jeongjo gave him the name Sado, which means thinking of sadness. Later, the young Jeongjo rose to the throne and moved his father's tomb from Seoul to Suwon, and he also wanted to move the capital from Seoul to Suwon. Because he wanted to build a happy utopia for his people and restore the honor of his father, Prince Sado. Suwon Hwaseong Fortress was a castle not seen in the previous Joseon Dynasty. In the castle, people built a reservoir, rice paddies, farms, houses, markets, and palace. Therefore, people could produce, distribute, and consume almost anything there. In addition, several original defense facilities were built here to effectively defend against the enemy invasion. Now let's take a look at the unique defense facilities installed on Suwon Hwaseong Fortress. What you see now is Gongsimdeon Observation Tower. It is a unique facility that can only be seen in Suwon Hwaseong Fortress. Gongsimdeon is named because it is empty inside. This is a three-story building. If the building is hit by enemy fire, only the part of it that was attacked will be punctured, and the entire building will not collapse, because it is empty inside. This pavilion was installed at the top of Gongsimdeon Observation Tower, which allowed soldiers to rest here during battle. This is a semicircular outer wall called the Ongsong. It was installed to attack enemies who break into the gates. On the Ongsong wall, soldiers were supposed to attack the enemies by using guns, arrows, stones, and etc. This is a crossbow tower called Noden. They were able to shoot mechanical multiple arrows here. This is a watchtower called Ganglu. Ganglu was built on a relatively high ground, allowing people to appreciate the superb scenery, as well as allowing the army to monitor the invasion of the enemy. If you follow the wall, you can see the parts that protrude forward on the fortress wall. This part is called Chiseong. On Chiseong, soldiers were supposed to attack enemies who were trying to climb up the wall. This sentry post is called Poru. In this way, a pavilion and cannons were installed on the top of Chiseong, allowing soldiers to fire cannons. In the middle of war, there are these small secret gates, which are called Amun. Through these gates, the military was supposed to carry food and weapons from outside, and to make surprise attacks on enemies surrounding the fortress. Of course, these doors were installed at a place where an enemy could not see. This is a beacon tower called Bongdon. Bongdon is not just a beacon tower, but also a defense facility that can attack enemies through holes like other defense facilities. These books are Royal Protocol for the Construction of Hwaseong Fortress, designated as UNESCO Memory of the World in 2007. The books perfectly describe the details of the construction of Suwon Hwaseong Fortress, including construction materials, wages paid to construction workers, construction tools, construction things, and so on. Actually, Suwon Hwaseong was badly damaged during Japanese colonial period and the Korean War in the 20th century. Fortunately, however, the Korean government referred to the books and completely restored the fortress to its original form in the 1970s. In the next episode, we will take a closer look at the major facilities of Suwon Hwaseong Fortress. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget like and subscribe. See you next time.